The internet is a delightful place, especially in school. We didn't have Game Boys or cell phones, so instead, as a class, we decided to improvise. And after further analysis, we only had two options to resort to. Really old iPads or broken laptops. If only they could use that money for teacher salaries. So yeah, we didn't really have a lot to go off of. And to make things more limited, websites were blocked. Like, tons of them. So we went and fixed that. This obviously affected teachers because they couldn't go on any educational websites or YouTube. But again, we found loopholes around it. One of them being as simple as putting the link in another language. But let's say we didn't have that ability. Websites were still blocked and there was nothing you can do about it. Well, I have some games that you can play to quench your thirst. In the computer lab, when you're supposed to be doing that essay. So, let's begin. I want you to turn off the Wi-Fi for your computer. Now type anything you want into the URL bar. If it says you have no internet, that's a good thing. Now hit the space bar. If you don't know what I'm talking about, Google basically just gives you a game to play when you have no internet. You're basically this dinosaur, and you have to run endlessly through a desert. That's it! That's the whole game! It's not much, but when you have an hour to kill during a computer lab, it's pretty good. The game was a score-based endless runner, so that means when it was played, it was mostly an Olympic competition. People with the highest amount of points were treated like kings. And on the other side of the spectrum, people with the lowest amount of points were basically just peasants. Okay, of course I'm exaggerating, but that's what it felt like. So, because I wanted to, I decided to play the game and see how far I could get. And I got 13,490 points. Here's proof. So that would obviously mean that I'm the king of kings. I also remember using cheat codes to see how many points you could get in one game. It turns out that it's infinite. So, for all you people who religiously play this game with friends, you can always one-up each other. Okay, now I want you to do me a favor. Think back to when you were in third grade. You were just introduced to this website. Everyone seems to call it coolmathgames.com. Now, this is something that's definitely for kids bored in study hall. I mean, look at what it's called. This was meant to confuse teachers. Cool Math Games is just a website where you play games. A bunch of kids, including me, just really loved playing these games. Now, it obviously didn't take long for teachers to find out that we were playing on the laptops. I think it's because someone snitched. I don't know who, though. We were always told that we're gonna get in trouble. That didn't even stop us. In fact, it kind of encouraged us more. Also, we made sure that we were alert. And I'll let you in on a little secret. When one person snitches, we all go down. So don't be that one guy. Okay, so I know that this isn't really considered browser, but I want to talk about this. So, remember those iPads that I briefly talked about? It was one of the first things I said today. Yeah, people would start downloading games on there. Except for me, though, because I was the kid with the highest morals. And no, I'm not talking about the second half of 8th grade. I wasn't the person to necessarily download the games, but I would just sit next to the person, watching them. But I'm not gonna snitch on the person. And of course, it didn't take long for the teachers to find out what our antics were. We retaliated by not listening. So, if there are any new 8th graders coming, you're welcome. In conclusion, the internet is a very broad place to explore anything. Playing games, looking up information, and just having a good time. And school computers were magical if you wanted that fix. It's something I like to call basic, but fun. Yay, new video's done. Alright, cool. I mean, 2 weeks. I could have did this in 1 week, but okay. Also, why am I recording this at 3 in the morning? And why am I venting out my current situation right now? Well, if you'll excuse me now, I'm gonna start editing this video. So now I go bye-bye.